good morning. A very heartfelt gratitude for showering your love and wishes for the soon-to-be newest member of our family. It sounds like there's so much of time, but really there is not. There's tons of preparations that we have to do before we are ready to welcome our baby. Things are different because if we were in India, we could have gotten help from family members, of course. But now that we are all by ourselves, we have to make sure that we have everything in place before the baby arrives. We are definitely planning to bring our parents over, but they can only join us in late April or early May, maybe. So by that time, we have to do most of the work. I know I have not been able to make a single post on Instagram and on my Facebook page since the last 2 weeks or so, maybe a little more than that. But I promise I'll get back to that because this pregnancy has been quite challenging health-wise, and I really need to keep myself sane. So in order to do all that, I took a break from all the social media except for YouTube. I try to keep it going. Sincerely hope you can understand how challenging this time has been. I really wanted to be present for my daughter most of the time. But this does not mean that I have not gotten her into doing activities and did not keep her spark alive. It's not like that. She has been doing it, various different activities as and when we got chance. Of course, the amount was little less as and less frequent as compared to what we would do before. But also, I could not share all those on my social media pages because, again, like I said, it required time and I really did not have time for all that. It was very surprising to me when I heard from my friends and some other followers on Instagram and Facebook page regarding why was I not sharing anything, is everything all right with me and all that. And I was really blown by these questions, and I felt that, okay, probably we are actually inspiring some other lives, some other families. So today's video is not a vlog. Today we are not going to vlog. Today's video will be mostly what we have been doing in the last 1 or 2 weeks with Navika and what's there on her shelf. So basically, I'm going to provide you a playroom tour again because I changed her playroom area. So as per her age, this is what our playroom looks like now. So let's get started. Okay, let me give you a quick tour of what it currently looks like. So this is the minimal setup that I have in her play area. I'll just try to pop in a picture of how it looked like before, and this is what it currently looks like. I've tried to give a new look to the play area, and I think it looks pretty nice and decent for her to be engaged with. Now I'll give you a closer look. These are all the books which she has on her shelf right now. There are other books which she takes out from time to time from the closet. We own some of the books, but there are also quite a few from the library. Like these three are from the library, which we have out here, and rest the books are in the closet. So I only keep a minimal number of books here, which are neatly displayed. Next, we'll move on to the shelf. These are the various toys that are out for now. Navika plays with all of these almost every day. Some days, some toys are untouched totally, and that's fine. This is a set which we got from her Kiwico subscription box, and we use it in various ways. When she was little, it was very much used for color recognition, cross motor. I'll share a video in which this has been used before, so I'll try to link it up here. And then currently we are trying to use this for memory activities. I'm sure you have seen this many times in our vlogs. She is totally obsessed with it, and it has just been out, like it was out of rotation for a while, and I just took it out few days back because she was back into this. She was asking for this, and so I thought that it will be great to bring it out. This is a DIY activity which I have created. We have four different textures here. So if you can see, this has beans, this has rice, this has semolina, and this has flour. So all these four are in these as well. So basically, she has to touch and match the texture, and once she finds the texture, she'll put it aside. The purpose of this activity is to learn the various textures just by the sense of feeling. Next, we have here some yoga cards. These yoga steps are to be done on her wobble board, like this one. So she performs yoga on this board. and it can be done on the top as well as on the underside by flipping it over. So this is something which she is very much interested in, and hence I have brought it out. Next, I have another set of puzzles here. I've increased the challenge level here. These are 48 pieces, and she has mastered the 24 pieces. Like she can solve it within 2 minutes. The next big number of pieces was 48, and this comes in a set of 3. She started to get a hold of how to identify things, so that, you know, how to put the pieces together. And I'm sure this is going to take a while for her to master. She's understanding the logic behind the puzzles. She's very much focused, concentrated, patient while solving this. And this has a lot of things to do with all those areas of, you know, behavioral development. So that's why this is out, and I don't find her frustrated at all when she is not able to find a piece. So that's a good thing. Since I have not seen her frustrated yet, it's out here. But if I find her getting frustrated over the puzzle pieces, then probably I'll remove it and then introduce it to her later. So this is all about these puzzles. I will try to link all of these products again in the description box below in case you are interested to get any of those. Okay, next we have these knobbed cylinders. These are called cylindrical blocks or knobbed cylinders. They also come without the knobs. Most importantly, it is used for like helping it with the proper grip of, you know, proper pencil grip. And this is, since this is how you're going to hold it, it helps with the with learning how to grip a pencil. These knobbed cylinders are pure Montessori materials, and it's introduced at around age 3, but I have already brought it out for Navika because for now she's just practicing to put it and finding the right fit for the various cylinders. These are primarily used to teach children to visually discriminate between the various dimensions. However, as competency grows, child can begin to differentiate with just the touch. Next, here we have some magnets, magnetic tiles. These are from the brand Connetix, and these have been used since ever. Like these magnet blocks and these wooden blocks from Love Every, these are always out. I have not attempted to remove these at all because Navika plays with these like every single day. The next thing here, we have these train set, and it's from IKEA. The main purpose of this train set is to build it oneself. You don't have, and again, this is not battery run, you have to do it all by yourself. So this helps the child gain more control over this, and also helps with all the various skills, like fine motor skills, because fitting these together also requires some strength and coordination. So this is one thing which Navika loves to play with, and hence this one is out now. And Love Every blocks, like I mentioned before, these are wooden blocks, and these have all possible shapes, and also have some peg people. So these are also used to build towers and whatnot, and Navika enjoys playing with these. This is what we have currently on our shelf, and I do not intend to remove these because these are used every single day. Next to this, we have her table and chair and her art card. I also got a few messages as in I should show what is there in her art card, so I'll just show it quickly. Here I have some colors. I just gave her a pencil also. These are some brushes that she uses to paint. This is the watercolor paint that I haven't given it to her. I couldn't find the plain one, so this one has glitter in it, and it's all right. It just adds a little bit more shine to the color, to the picture. So that's fun. These are some craft sticks here, the plain ones, which is used for various open-ended plays or activities. These are some more craft sticks which I have used, and like I have velcroed them, and I've shown this in my previous video too. And this is also kept out because she likes to come back time to time with this and play with it. So it has velcro on all the sides, and then you can make a triangle out of this, and you can make a square out of this. So this is fun for her. Next, I have a dot marker. This I got from the Dollar Tree. Navika is not interested in dot markers still, so I did not get the whole set, and I just got a one, like a cheap one, so that to see if she ever likes it. Once I see that she is interested, probably I'll get a new one. This is a sand timer. This is a 2-minute timing, and it helps her to learn. If I say that, you know, let's wait for 2 minutes, then she'll quickly go and grab this, and that way she gets an idea that this timer is for 2 minutes. Once all the sand is down, when the sand is over from the top section, that means the time is up and then we can do whatever we were supposed to do. I have some more colors here. This came in a set, but these are the only two remaining and hence they are out. Once this is over, this will be gone. These are some more, I don't know what is this. These are some more colors. These are actually the finger paints which I introduced to her when she was like 1 year old, and then like I got the refill pack and I have filled them up. So this is still with us. These are some crayons. Okay, some more colors which I got for her. But this is here in a set. These are the ones from her previous sets, and as you can see there are different kinds of colors here. So these are the ones which have not dried out yet and are still in use. So once these are over, probably after that we'll get this one out. But she has complete access to this set also, and she plays with it, colors with it, and then puts it back. Next, here we have materials for her sensory play. These are used for her dry sensory play, like when she plays with rice or sensory corn or beads, things like that. This is used with those materials. This is used with her Play-Doh. So this is from her shape sorter toy when she was little, and there are some others which I made. These are all the ones which I made myself. These are the thick rolls, and this holds, these stay strong, so these are good for making such DIY patterns. So I have some with zigzag pattern, dotted patterns, and these are horizontal lines. These are cork screws on which I put some letters, which are actually the letters of her name. So she finds it fun using these. So these are for the Play-Doh. Here I have another for kinetic sand play. So these are used for her kinetic sand, and I've put all of them here. This is slime here. This is kaleidoscope, though it's I have put it in the art card because we don't have space for this one here in her cubbies, but she likes playing with this and looking through this. So this is out here and I put it here in her art card, so she has easy access to these. Next, on the bottom tier, I have kinetic sand for her. This has some Play-Doh that I made at home. So these are homemade Play-Doh. I have one in red and the other one in green, the bottom one. And this is salt. This is colored salt, which is used for tracing letters. And probably I'll try to show it in a separate video how this salt is used. And then here I have some cutting strips for her. So some of these were black and white, so she has colored those and then she tries to cut them. This is a good way of practicing cutting skills, and all the cutouts are put, she puts it here. And then I really have to clear this cup. Here I have this threading leaf that I got for her, I made for her. This is simply, I took a print from giftofcuriosity.com and I've laminated and punched holes, and then I have a shoelace here. I bought a new shoelace, and you can use the, like you can also use if you have a spare one, but I did not. So she loves threading this leaf. So this is one thing. These are all the things we have here on her art card, and these are out on a daily basis. So I guess that's it. And next I'll just show you this particular shelf. This is a latch board that I got her last Christmas, and she loves to play with it still. So this was out of rotation. I just brought it out a few days back. Here I have her xylophone. In this cup there are some crayons which she has, as you can see, she has peeled. These were all broken and I asked her to peel them up. So now that this is done, she uses these crayons for this book. I got her a big preschool book, and this is good for tracing lines. So I got her a pencil for that. I showed you, it's there in the art card. So she does all these. So she's into tracing, and after this there are some places where you need to color. She used color pens here, and that's when I told her that if you use color pens, this is what happens on the back of the page. So she has now, for now, she has understood it, and she's using crayons wherever possible. Though she is not completing the picture, as you can see, but yeah, she is getting there, and probably she'll sit through it. I've realized painting through crayons is something which she's not appreciative of. Probably I should get a better material, and this is not what she likes. Anyway, this is the latch board. Here I have the xylophone, colors, the book. This is her doctor kit, which is out all the time because she loves taking care of everyone, of all her stuffed toys and us. So this is always out. Next, I have this kinetic sand box. It has all the tools that it came with, and she just has to take this out and put it on her table, and then bring out her kinetic sand, which is kept in her art card, and then play with it. After it's done, we put this back here. This is a rolling pin which I use for her Play-Doh. It's quite sturdy, so this is good for her, and not very heavy too, so she can handle it herself. I have her dust mitt and her dustpan and brush set here, so she can clean up if there's a mess. And this sensory bin is also always out. Currently it is filled with corns, some pebbles. She, for no reason, she has put some shells also. She wanted some cupcake liners, some egg cases, and all her construction vehicles. She's obsessed with construction vehicles. So this is her favorite set of all time, and she's still playing with these. And yeah, that's what we have here. I'll try to put links to all of these things that you have seen in the video in the description box of this video. But yeah, if you have any other questions, just let me know, and I'll be happy to address those. And yes, of course, I need to mention again, those picture frames have been out for since the time I have set this playroom. But sometimes I feel of changing the pictures, though it still looks good. I'm not quite sure, but yeah, hanging pictures at the child's height level is really a pleasant experience for the child, and it's beautiful actually. And of course, a plant to add to the beauty. It helps the child to take care of the plant. So some days if I forget to water it, she reminds me of doing so, and hence I have purposefully put one chair here and some space here so that she can take it out and water the plant all by herself. Now that she can do it independently, I don't really have to worry about it. Earlier I had to take the plant down and then water it, but now she can do it directly there. So yeah, that's it about my play area tour. Let me know if you have any questions, and I'll be happy to answer those. Thank you for checking out this video, and if you have not subscribed to the channel yet, I would request you to please subscribe it. I upload one video every Tuesday. Normally I upload vlogs on every Tuesday, but I'm currently pregnant with my second baby girl, and it's been quite challenging to bring more videos in a week. Hence I'm taking this time out and bringing videos which have been very much requested. So yeah, I hope you guys like it, and if you do, please give it a thumbs up, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you next week. Bye.